morning, students. This is my second lecture. I am going to teach you as per the NCERT page number 2. What are that? That is the characteristic of the particles of the matter. In the previous class, we have discussed what is the matter. Anything that have mass and occupies a space are called matter. The things all around we see, anything we touch it, we feel it, we lift it up, bench, chair, table, or even the blackboard and the chalk, anything, even yourself and myself, desk, podium, building, everything is a matter because it is having mass and they occupy it, a space. Children, the matter we have discussed, taking the reference of the ancient and Indian philosopher also. Now I am entering to the second lesson. Here we have to study the what are the characteristics of the particles of the matter. What are the characteristics? What the particles of the matter does it? How the particles of the matters are hold? How these particles are arranged? How these particles are behaving? Matters is made out of particles. Minute. Now you tell me these particles of the matter, what is the characteristic of particles of the matter? So first, particles of the matter have a space between them. Anything, water is a matter, sugar is a matter, Dettol is a matter, potassium permanganate is a matter, copper sulfate is a matter. I told you in the previous class, we have got that we took the water, in that we have dissolved the sugar. Sugar got dissolved into it. Now what happens? Where the sugar has gone? There was no level of the water has raised. There was no increase in the level of water. Then where the sugar has gone? Sugar has occupied the space between the water molecules. In the water molecules, there is a space where the sugar has occupied it. Earlier it was vacant. On that basis, we have concluded that the particles of the matter is very small, beyond imagination. Now, the particles of the matter have a space between them. We have proved it. We have added the Dettol. We have added the sugar. And it is thoroughly mixed. So, we have proved that already the particles of matter have a space between them. Today's class, we will discuss you, the particles of the matters are continuously moving. The particles of the matter is not static. It has a kinetic energy. It is too small. It is continuously moving like this. Now I have to explain this, the particles of the matter are continuously moving by using an activity. Day to day you feel it in your house. I will show you the activity also. In somebody's house, in your neighbor, somebody is cooking the fish. The aroma of the fish, you smell it. And then you say, the neighbor has in your house, neighbor, that in your house today fish is there. Reason behind the aroma of the fish is reaching to you through the kinetic energy. Because these particles are continuously moving and that aroma has reached to your nose and you smell it. Some of your friend is using the perfumes and you are at some other corner, then also you feel it and say that you have used perfumes. Because that smell reaches to you, the aroma or the smell of that nature has come to your nose, and then you are recognizing the what exactly it is. Now the children, something, some animal or rat is dead in your house. You started searching due to the smell, where is the rat is lying. Text example, I am taking that as per your book, activity number. Say, as per your book, activity number 1.3. Activity 1.3 says that put an unlit essence stick in the corner of your house and close to you have the, go near to it, so get it this smell. Now light the incense stick. And what happens, what do you get that? How you get the smell from the far distance, that your observation? Children, it is a magic, incense stick. I taking this incense stick, to smell it, we have to come to closer. It is kept in the corner of the house. We cannot get the smell from far away. If you keep the corner of the house, you cannot get a smell here. Now light it up. Now, children, I have lighted up the incense stick. This is a smoke. It is clearly visible and continuously moving. Wherever this smoke will go, you will be able to feel and smell it. So, this property, what you observe by doing this, you observe that the particles of the matter are continuously moving. It travels one place to another place. But in the case of when it was not lighted up, we go near to that to smell it. Now, you can show it also. Now I put up the matchstick in the almira, and now I am smelling it. It is because due to the temperature, the rise in temperature, this incense stick is lighted up. Hence temperature is higher. Due to this higher temperature, kinetic energy of the molecules, particles are more. Hence it reaches to us. Due to increase in kinetic energy of the particles, it has reached to us. So, now we will discuss furthermore, the particles of that matter are continuously moving. Another activity, as per your book, activity number 1.4. I have explained you the activity 1.3 by using the incense stick. Activity number 1.4. Take two beaker or anything in which one must have the water, another have honey, and put the color in both the container. Both the beaker and leave them undisturbed. Now record your observation. What do you observe? Immediately after putting the ink drop. Let's see and observe. So it is. Children, now I am taking the activity number 1.3. We have taken the two beakers. Each beaker is having, one has got the water, another has got the honey. Now I am going to put the color into that. Now you observe it, what we are going to do with it. Now you see how it is getting mixed the white color. Slowly it is diffusing into it. I can show you by using the another color also. You may feel that white color may not be much ink. We will go with the red color. Check it now. how the color is coming out and getting distributed. Now children, the same thing I wanted here, I am doing the same thing in the honey. Now check it, the dissolution is very slow. Once again we will show you. The diffusion is very slow. Now, please see the second activities. I have told you 1.3, 1.4. Write your observation. We observe conclusion, we observe that the color is diffusing faster in the case of water, but the color faster in the case of water, but color does not diffuses in the case of honey, because honey is much thicker. The rate of diffusion is very slow in honey. The color does not mix in honey faster, but it mix faster in the case of water. It is because the both proves that the particles of the matter are continuously moving. I have shown you in the essence stick also, here also continuously moving, but the movement of the particles depends upon the medium. Medium is, it is a denser medium. Honey is a denser medium and water is a rarer medium as compared to each other. Therefore, it moves slowly. Now again, activity number third. Activity number 1.5, my third activity, we will explain you how the diffusion takes place. Here also, we will take two containers, two conical flasks. One conical flask is having one. Now observe this activity. We have got two conical flasks. One conical flask is having boiling water. Now see, it is getting boiled, and another has got cold water. Now in both water, we will put the crystals of copper sulfate, 50-50, half. See, it is the equal amount. We have copper sulfate crystals. One I will be putting in hot water. Another I will be putting in cold water. Now see, both I will put at a time. Now see, what actually happens. Both you observe it. Now children, you have seen that hot water copper sulfate crystal is dissolved. It is diffused faster, but here it is slowly diffusing it. Here you can see it is slowly diffusing it. The crystals are clearly visible. It takes time. Now see and observe it. Particles of the matter are continuously moving. They possess the kinetic energy. The temperature rises, the particle moves faster. In the case of hot water, the movement of particle was faster and it dissolved. While in the case of cold water, the kinetic energy of the particles is lesser and it is still visible. It depends upon the different types of matter and having the different properties or the rate of diffusion of matter depends upon the nature of particles. It is intermixing of the particles are called diffusion. It is intermixing of particles by their own is known as diffusion. Now I am concluding it, this part. We will go to the next part. We have already explained particles of the matter are continuously moving. Now my third property, characteristic property, that particles of the matter attract each other. Particles of the matter attract each other. How can you explain it? By day to day using example, you are putting your finger underneath the water tap. You see that you cut the water flow in two directions and again the water moves and then join it. The flow of water is like this. It is the water is flowing. You are putting your finger over here. The water moves like this. Here moves like this. Again it is flowing like this. This activity shows that particles of matter attract each other. Another activity, as per your NCERT book, activity number 1.6, activity number 1.7, and activity number 1.8. We will be explaining each and every. Now activity number 1.6. Take the examples of 5-6 your friends. 6-6 friends. You make 4 lots. 1 lot, they are locking their hands like a view dance. They will lock their elbows and make the formation of view dance. At the same time, your second friend will make a human chain by holding 6 of your or 7 of your friends. And third group will be touching each and everyone's hand like this. They will be making a human chain. Fourth group will be told, चौथे ग्रुप को हम ये बताएंगे कि जाके उनको तोड़ो. Which will be easier to break? The molecule, the is imagine it. Those are holding like a view dance. It will be very difficult to break it. But those are holding like a hand. It can be easily separated. So, the particles of matter, the force of attraction depends. When the matter has a stronger force of attraction, it requires more amount of energy to break. And which has got lesser force of attraction, it can be easily broken. So the team which was holding hand like a view dance, imagine every children is an atom or a particle of matter. Then the first one case was very difficult to break it as compared to the second, and last one was very easy to break it. Children, another activity we will discuss it. Take a small iron nail, piece of chalk and rubber. Try breaking them by hammering, cutting or stretching. In which of the above three substances do you think that particle is held together with greater force? I am taking the nail, iron nail, rubber band and the chalk. Three things we have. Now check it what I am doing. Nothing happens. It is a rubber band. Now, try to understand which one has a greater strength. Which one is more held together by more stronger forces? Conclusion is that the iron nail is much stronger. The particles are held together by a stronger force, greater force as compared to the rubber, and chalk has got the weakest force. between their particles. Therefore, I was able to break the chalk much easily as compared to the nail or rubber. Now take a third activity number 1.8. Take some water in a container and try cutting the surface of water with your feet. The force keep the particles together. The strength of the force of attraction varies from one kind of matter to another kind of matter. The strength of the force, if you cut the water, you are not able to cut it. See, I am cutting it, but I am not able to cut it. We cannot cut into two pieces because these particles of the matter attract each other. When I am cutting it, again it is going to be attracted each other and joined together. Now, children, I have covered that the particles of the matter are continuously moving. We have given you the three activities. One activity is sensistic. Another activity I have explained you by using the hot water and cold water. And third activity, water and honey. Then particles of the matter attract each other. I have told you the activity by using the water, by breaking the, another activity by breaking the nail or chalk and rubber. Now, or cutting the supply of flow of water. All three activity prove that the particles of the matter attract each other. Now, the NCERT exercise questions, we will be discussing it within few minutes. That we will be discussing, you know. Just a minute. Let me discuss it and close this. I will give you the NCERT book. NCERT in-text question, page number 3. The topic is getting over today. Now look at the question number 3 here. Don't see the answer. You see the first questions. They are asking you for answer of every questions. What first question says? Which of the following are matter? Chair is a matter. Air is a matter. Love is not a matter. A smell is not a matter. Hate is not a matter. Almond is a matter. Thought is not a matter. Cold is not a matter. Lemon is a matter. Water is a matter. A smell of perfumes is not a matter. The smell of perfumes is, you will feel that a smell is not a matter, but a smell of perfumes will be a matter because the different smells of the perfumes will come to you through the transmission. The hot. Give the reason for the following observation. The smell of hot sizzling food reaches you several meters away. But to get the smell from the cold food, you have to go too close. It is because in the case of hot food, the particles of the aroma possess the kinetic energy, and due to the kinetic energy, the hot food aroma reaches to us, whereas the cold food aroma does not have particles, does not have much kinetic energy. Therefore, we need to go near to the cold food. Now, the question number 3. A diver is able to cut through the water in a swimming pool. Which Which property of the matter does this observation shows? A diver is diving in the water and then it cuts the water and enters. Which property is so? Again, water level is joined when it dives inside. It shows that the particles of the matter attract each other. Particles of the matter attract each other. I told you already, when you cut off the water by your finger, what are the characteristics of the particles of the matter? We have already discussed on the blackboard. Particles of matter have a space between them. Particles of the matter are continuously moving, and particles of the matter attract each other. So, gentlemen, we have covered this topic, and coming class, we will be going to the states of matter. So, by then, page number 1, 2, and 3 cover thoroughly and go through my lecture. And do all the exercise questions. Thank you.